Stay yours, kiddo.
Hey, Art Family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. This video is a sponsored video by the Evolve Art School. A couple months back, an art school reached out to me asking if I'd be willing to check out their program and then do a video talking about my first couple blocks that I do in the program. The school is Evolve Art School. They're an online school, and so far I've really enjoyed it. I really appreciate how communicative the professors are at the school, the teachers. They're all very hands-on in talking to you and working with you on the blocks and the program and keeping in touch with you through the week. So they check in on your work, they talk to you, they give you direct feedback for every assignment, and then they answer questions directly, which I really appreciated because it's a lot of times these schools, sometimes they tend to sort of have to drop the program and move on to the next thing that they're teaching. So I really appreciate it that they're very hands-on in the program and they answer your questions and talk to you directly. And I even had a private meeting with their head instructor, Piper, who was incredibly kind and generous with her time and knowledge.
And I want to make sure that no one, you know, misses that foundational education, right? It's so important because you can build on that and go wherever you want, right? If you want to sculpt, if you want to be a sculptor, if you want to be an illustrator, you know, move more into kind of a stylistic approach to art, you can do that with an understanding of the fundamentals and with an education of realism. You can kind of go anywhere.
We spent a lot of our conversation talking about teaching art because I have taught art for a while as well, and programs are very difficult to build because you have to kind of balance something that is both satisfying for the person taking the class, yet also, you know, generous with knowledge and teaching someone an actual skill that they can build on, which can be very difficult because those two things don't necessarily always line up, because there's a tendency for, if you're doing a painting that's very satisfying and you get to feel like you've completed a good painting, a lot of times it's because you followed steps so much that you aren't actually building on a skill that you can grow with. So when I'm working on a program for teaching, I always like to try to keep in mind that I'm trying to teach people to teach themselves down the road, which is unfortunately a lot of times less satisfying in the short term. But in the long term, hopefully, if you're very passionate, you can sort of build and grow on those skills for the future. In doing the steps that I've done and in talking with Piper from the school, they have a similar mindset in that the school is really trying to teach you to build on the knowledge that they teach you so that you can deliver a consistent, strong painting every time.
And I think that that idea of intention comes from an understanding of what you're doing and an understanding of color mixing, value, edge, technique, approach, all of these things. And then experience, right? Experience does matter.
Sure.
And you know, you learn as you go, as you make paintings, you learn. But yeah, that intention is important, and intention is everything in art. And having a solid education, having an understanding of the fundamentals and how to get a result helps you to be intentional and honest.
The program in the beginning takes you through these very basic exercises. The first four steps in the program are mostly basic, filling in a shape, learning how to build gradients and apply gradients clean and even in a kind of perfect manner. And then you get into doing the still lifes where you start to break things down in a very basic scale of value, which is crucial to painting. I really liked how they right away start in with a simplified idea of value rather than trying to immediately start you off with like a 10 step or even bigger scale of gradients. I like that they send you four tubes of paint. It limits the amount of kind of crazy variation, and the teacher is very specific in how you apply those paints and where those specific grades of value go. So you can't get too lost. There's a pretty solid path in terms of learning a very fundamental, difficult skill in any kind of painting, whether it's watercolor or oil painting, which is just learning how to simplify the values of a scene. You only have these four steps of value, and then you get a blend between them that he builds with a kind of method of shifting, kind of like a car, which I thought was interesting and a good analogy for it. But it's very helpful because he applies a very sort of visual idea to how you're shifting between these four values and applying those to the painting directly, and you build slowly. And having gone now through most of the first block, I like that they build these steps in a very understandable manner that doesn't get away from you too fast. And each skill applies to the next lesson, which I found really helpful and interesting. I know for me, I thought, well, because I have enough skill built up from the years of practice that maybe at least I can kind of blow through the beginning, hopefully, and move right into the sort of meat of what's going on in the program. I actually found I got snagged in the beginning because I have not spent a lot of time focusing on the fundamentals of brushwork, having taught myself how to paint, and spending most of my time working in watercolor and gouache. I tend to paint very haphazardly, and so I have not spent a lot of time working on very specific skills like using the brush and filling a shape, or what really got me was trying to focus on having perfect clean gradients. I really appreciated that the school sends you the materials. Art education costs can vary so widely, from free videos on YouTube to I have friends that still owe $200,000 for college. It's hard to price a program, but I do appreciate that it is very hands-on and that they do send you really high-quality materials, which is nice, because a lot of schools, when they send you materials, they'll send student grade stuff, and then it's always this constant uphill battle to try to get past the fact that the materials are sort of working against you. So I really liked that they give you the good materials so that you can deliver a good product with what you're doing. They also have a very active, vibrant community online for their students where people are encouraging each other and talking to one another, which I really appreciated as well. They have constant little workshops as well, which I thought was very cool. When you're in the program, they have a calendar that fills you in on whatever mini workshop is coming up. And they also have little pop-up classes that will come up every once in a while, videos that talk about selling art and things like that. I really like the school. And I've had a great time working through block one. I'm 3/4 of the way through, and I do plan to continue on and move on to the next block. I find that the program's been good for me in that it's helped me develop more skills using a brush, and I find it's changed the way that I think about applying paint, moving paint around. Even in my watercolors, it's sort of changed the way I think about things. I've kind of brought that a little bit more of a technical precision to the way that I handle shapes when I'm setting shapes in a painting.
If you're interested in more information about Evolve, I'll leave a link in the description of this video.
Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.